the Montreal Canadiens are headed to Winnipeg for the second round. And now they've won three in overtime. They've won the North.
Well, fresh off the Montreal Canadiens surprising the hockey world again, I'm very pleased to be joined by Arpan Basu, the editor-in-chief of The Athletic Montreal. Thanks so much for doing this.
My pleasure, Rob.
Okay, let's start with a simple one. I mean, if I told you before the playoffs, you and I would be talking right now as the Montreal Canadiens were fresh off beating the Leafs and then sweeping the Jets. How shocked would you have been?
Surprised. Shocked would be, I guess, not the word I would use. I mean, listen, I really did think they had a chance to beat the Maple Leafs. I thought that the team that we saw at the regular down the stretch in the regular season was not the actual team that they were. I'm surprised at how quickly they were able to come together in that series, in the sense that, you know, they had the 8-day break leading into it, which I thought was going to be really beneficial to them. They got healthy. They had their full team. But when they were down 3-1, it was like they flipped a switch and really became a team. And it's really, that was surprising to me at how quick that flipped. And really, it wasn't that quick because, you know, even though they played really well in games 5 and 6, they were an overtime goal away from being knocked out. So, but still, their game changed significantly in those games. And you saw what I think everyone saw coming into the season, which was, you know, think back to the offseason and how many people were saying the Canadiens are built for the playoffs. Look at everything Marc Bergevin has done. They're a playoff team. They're going to be tough to handle in the playoffs. And then the whole season happened and you were like, okay, well, this team doesn't look that great, especially, you know, they get off to a hot start. People are calling them juggernauts, myself included. And then they go into a spin and they never really get out of it. And the only reason they made the playoffs is because, you know, Calgary and Vancouver basically were in worse spins than they were. So, but this is really the team that myself and I think a lot of people around the hockey world looked at all the moves that Marc Bergevin made in the offseason and said, this is a team that's going to be difficult to face in the playoffs, and now we're seeing it.
All right, let's talk about Carey Price. And I know you wrote about him in The Athletic, and you talked about how this is different than anything Carey Price has seen in the playoffs in his career. And I'm wondering how much of that is just Carey Price going to superhuman-type levels, and Carey Price finally having at least a little bit of support offensively from his teammates.
Yeah, I think it's a mixture of both, and frankly, I'm surprised to see to what extent Price is able to deal with the current situation, in the sense that he's used to having tons of action, tons of zone time in his end. Like, he's used to carrying this team. And I think against Toronto, it would be fair to say that he did carry them through the end of that series. He was the trigger point that really turned that thing around for them. Not that he played badly in the first four games, far from it, but he was the backbone for that resurgence that the team was able to do. He provided them the leeway to find their game. But since then, I mean, against the Jets, I mean, he was definitely a factor and he played extremely well. But I wouldn't say he was the number one factor in the Canadiens winning that series, sweeping that series, which was also kind of surprising that it was done that quickly. But, you know, the cohesion of the Canadiens, you know, 5-on-5 game in front of them, and really the forward lines coming together and playing really specific, distinct roles and playing so well together. You know, this is something Carey Price has never seen, playoffs, regular season, what have you. The Jets had 16 shots on goal in game 4. I had to look it up, but that's the fewest shots Carey Price has ever seen in a playoff game in his career. And, you know, I mean, it was a funny soundbite for everyone, but like, I had to ask Price if that was difficult for him, having only 16 shots in a game, staying focused. And his answer was perfect.
We won.
And that's all he cares about right now.
Okay, all that being said, though, is it me or does Carey Price look way calmer than we've seen him look in the past? I mean, he's making spectacular highlight reel glove saves look really, really easy.
I honestly think with the years, he's become cognizant of the psychological impact that has on his opponents. The year that Carey Price swept the awards, I was in Vegas covering the awards and I spoke to John Tavares about it. It was the best quote I've heard about him because it's true. It's like you can really tag a shot. You can get all of it. You can put it exactly where you want it. And Carey Price will stop it as if it's a tennis ball bouncing into the net. And it's just demoralizing. Like, it's just like, it makes you feel inadequate as a shooter. And so you know, there was times when Carey Price was younger, he would make those saves and he would hot dog a little bit, like most goalies do, you know. They're like, listen, I just made a great save, I'm going to make it look good. I think he's come to realize that making it not look good has more of an impact on his opponents than so when it looks easy to him, that's when shooters are like, man, I have to make a perfect shot.
Got to talk to you about Cole Caulfield. I had someone recently ask me, you know, what's the deal with this kid? And I said, he kind of reminds me of Rudy with a lot more skill. And obviously his stature comes into play when I make that comparison, but every time he does anything, be it in the regular season, in the playoffs, in his short time as a Montreal Canadian, it seems as though his teammates absolutely love him.
You know, Caulfield's coming in, he's 20 years old, and the difference to Rudy is that Caulfield is no walk-on. You know, Caulfield is a blue chip prospect coming in with all the skill in the world and with a willingness to learn and embrace his weaknesses and work on them. And if you watch his game, you know, everyone says that in the video set, especially Dominique Ducharme, to what extent he's receptive to details. Ducharme has said it more than once where there'll be a game situation, something will be pointed out to him, the same game situation comes up again, and he's already adapted the next time it happens. That's the kind of stuff that will get the veteran teammates around you rallying on your side.
Got to ask you about the most talked about moment in that series. Mark Scheifele with his hit on Jake Evans that cost him 4 games. After the series was all said and done, he finally spoke to the media about it, and he said this.
You know, I thought I was going to be tried to shut down by Philip Deneau, and you know, it was Department of Player Safety that shut me down. So that definitely sucks. You know, they knocked me out of the series. You know, I don't even get a chance to play with my teammates and battle with my teammates in the series. You know, for a guy with a clean record, I'm just going to stop talking before I get fined or something like that. So I'll just leave it as it is.
One, what were your thoughts when you first heard that quote? And two, Jake Evans, I know he's not an all-star. I know he's never going to be in the running for, say, a Hart Trophy. But he's been so big on that shutdown line. How big of a hole is he going to cause in that lineup if he doesn't play a lot in the next round?
The first question on Scheifele is, you know, I mean, hockey teams, hockey coaches, hockey culture calls for accountability all the time. I mean, I don't know how a guy can watch his team get swept where he's their top offensive player and he's not playing based on something he himself decided to do, whether he agrees or disagrees with the suspension. He clearly disagrees with it. And that's debatable, that whether it was too long or not. I think they finally got one right personally, but you know, I was expecting 2 games for him. Let's say it was two games. And the Jets lose those 2 games and they're down 3-0. Does that really make a huge difference? Scheifele's actions already negatively impacted his team. And you would think a hockey player who has grown up in a culture of accountability his entire life would be able to be accountable in that moment. So, I mean, someone needs to sit him down and talk to him and say, hey, listen, yes, maybe the Department of Player Safety made a severe decision, but they made a severe decision based on your actions. And maybe you need to own that a little bit. Regarding Jake Evans, yes, it's a hole. Yes, it's a wonderful story. 7th round draft pick, 4 years at Notre Dame, you know, worked his way up through the AHL. Is really the Canadiens' first development success story under Joel Bouchard. Became, you know, somewhat of an indispensable player in that Leafs series. Really changed the look of that Deneau line with Gallagher when he replaced Tomáš Tatar, who was being quite ineffective for the second playoffs in a row. You could argue third playoffs in a row after he was scratched in Vegas before getting traded to Montreal. And so, you know, really and made that into a true shutdown line. The Canadiens had the luxury, however, of having a guy like Arturi Lehkonen, who was out with a concussion and sitting on the sidelines just waiting to replace Evans. And if there's one player on this Canadiens who can perfectly, you know, mirror what Jake Evans offers that line, it's Arturi Lehkonen.
I get it now, Arpan. Evans is Rudy. He went to Notre Dame.
Yes, Evans is Rudy. Absolutely. You want to talk about a walk-on, that's a 7th round draft pick, goes to the AHL. Yes, that's a way better comparison. Jake Evans, 4 years at Notre Dame, 7th round pick, and basically walks on to the Canadiens as a guy who was in Laval. So yes, everything comes full circle, man. Cole Caulfield is the star quarterback, and Jake Evans is Rudy.